So I am back here with my colleague and CEO Luca over here. That is hello. Hey, look, I'm so sorry for the dark, and I don't know why it happened. Their NTP stream just completely went down, and then took a little bit of time to get things back up. So, and hey, sorry, hiccups happen. We'll learn next time, and I'm so sorry. Things video on YouTube is going to be posted, I think, more or less right now, or sooner rather than, or almost right now. So, and while I take care of that, there will also be an accompanying blog post to cover everything. So, Luca, what did you announce? What was all of this about?
So today we launched two new features, and then we opened the gates for our Platformatic Cloud. We the first feature that we announced was PR Previews, a phenomenal feature that was highly demanded first by us, or at least by me when I was a developer, to solve one of the most common problems. When I build an API, I clearly follow my Git flow. And how do I get people to test my PR in a real life environment, like with real consumers, with real mobile apps, real website. The other feature is Workspaces. That is kind of a feature in a feature. With Workspaces, we are unlocking the power of creating environments. But we like to call them workspaces because we love to decouple them from the pure infrastructure and more to group logically and physically services and applications. And that actually is a phenomenal addition because right now we will be able then to start promoting our code. And last but not least, we launched our cloud in December, and it was invite only. We have an overwhelming amount of people asking to join it. And with these new features, we decided to open Platformatic Cloud to everyone. So the first tier that is available for everyone is the free tier, which allow you to have one dynamic and one static workspaces, and probably something that you want to deep dive on the difference between those two types. And will allow you to create your first app on our cloud. Like I said in the video, stay tuned. There are many more features to come, and soon more addition to this to our cloud offering. And on the open source side, we released the Platformatic client, which I think you're gonna deep dive more on why it's so phenomenal. I have to say that Platformatic Cloud, together with the client, has been two things that I've been looking for a very long time when building platform. So I'm extremely excited as being part with you of this journey on creating it, but also as a consumer to have something that finally reflects what I've been looking for a long time.
Amazing, Luca. Amazing. So look, I'm so, so excited about everything. And I just received a random question from a friend watching the live stream, and he asked me, yeah, but you know, they were talking about how can they use their custom domain, and do we have anything on that topic?
Yeah, we have something ready, but not yet to go for everyone. So we stay tuned. In a few weeks, we will add support for custom domains to our workspaces. We are just finishing up all the testing and wrapping things up to make it available for everyone to consume.
Amazing. Oh, Is there something else? Let me see. So how do there is this interesting question? How do workspace work for apps? Why would I use dynamic versus a static workspace?
So the dynamic workspace wants to reflect our first feature, the PR previews. So the dynamic workspace basically gives you an environment where you can actually continuously deploy those PRs, and each PR will have a unique URL. And we have some smart, some secret sauce, like we say, you know, for our Italian recipes, that makes the sauce very interesting, because machines, we utilize the machine to run all these PRs, and so they have a very short life cycle. While where static workspaces, they actually are long living. So you have a URL for your whole life cycle of your workspace. Extremely powerful when you think about the workflow, the normal GitOps, the Git flow. So I push code to a PR, this PR needs to be tested, some people testing. Then is approved, it goes into staging. Staging is going to another phase of test, and then you have finally production. So that's exactly what we're stitching together with these two types of workspaces.
Amazing, Luca. Cool. So, and then there is something more, okay? And they kept something that is, do you know? So at some point we were chatting and moving around. I think we were in London, where we started thinking about building something like a client, how to interconnect multiple programmatic applications together. Why we implemented that? Like, it seems hard a little bit, like, you know, right now you can just deploy a single platformatic application to the cloud. So why would you need a client for?
Tough question. So the big advantage of having a client is that we are, first of all, providing a foundation for our users to standardize on the way platformatic the same service or from other service inbound to a platformatic service. The cool thing is that most of the time, when I was a developer a long time ago, probably, the main challenge is to keep that connection based on schema. So your data contract and your service contract always up to date. And we saw technologies in the past, like WCF, for example, attempting to do that. And I think the very powerful feature that Platformatic Client brings is exactly that nostalgia, plus the power of having schema-full connections. I would not even call it connection, they're mostly wiring. Consolidated schema. I think it gets even more interesting when you think about a distributed system, when you add more services, because the complexity clearly becomes exponential. And now that's where Platformatic Client gets very, very interesting. If you have a little bit of patience, you will see how this is the first piece of a bigger puzzle. But just a little bit of patience. We can't open everything up immediately.
Okay. So stay tuned for more announcements. Okay, it's something that's going to happen very soon. So I'm very 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 happy about things. Okay, so it's kind of phenomenal. To more or less, I'm very very, I don't know, excited. So let's look at this. Where there are some more questions. This is actually very easy. I'm going to answer this. How can folks get started with Platformatic? This was actually a very easy easy question. So the simplest one is the simplest way is you can just do npm create Platformatic and at latest whatever, and it will just automatically get the latest generator and create all the latest things and set up a project. You do it on an empty folder. You might want to do that in an empty Git repo, but that's up to you. If you do that in an empty Git repo, you can then push that to once it's running your that create Platformatic thingy, we can create, I don't know, some little bit of scaffolding and demo app, which is a basic application with movies and quotes, nothing very very specific, and just to demonstrate a little bit a couple of things, and you create a Platformatic DB with those things, and then you can just deploy it to the cloud. Okay, with Platformatic Cloud, you can just and this is actually where things gets very interesting. Cloud, there is no concept of cloud build minutes. We don't have any build minutes. You just use your own GitHub action minutes, and you can just run the bundle. You like compose our big tarball and then ship the tarball up to our cloud, and we take that tarball and deploy it to Node 18 and the latest Platformatic version, and everything is magically up and running, and it's great. So I'm very, very excited, and it's actually very easy to get started. I was chatting recently with a friend in Florence, and they were telling me that they were just was super easy to get things started. Okay, so, and they were just like, oh, I started doing the building the backend, and in an hour I was just finished, and it's amazing. So pretty cool, right? So there are a couple of more questions. Luca, this one is for you. This one is more for me, because it's what is the advantages of having long-running Node.js services compared to, I don't know, functions and serverless and things like that? Well, first of all, you know that there are all those fancy so when you're building your applications, typically you need to talk to a database, right? And when you talk to a database, you typically have a connection to that database. And with all these fancy serverless and lambdas and things like that, in order to do exactly just that, you need to do some shenanigans, because for every single time you reach a request, they will actually issue you, you need to actually create a new connection and do all sorts of things. With long-running processes, nope, there's no need. Okay, all your requests are going to come in and run through your Node.js processes, and everything is going to be exactly fine. And without all the cost of, and all the costs related to the single execution. Not that, you know, with Lambdas, you pay by execution time, while right now Platformatic is free, but at some point, yeah, you can expect some money. We'll charge a little bit of money, okay? The key thing is that because our processes are long running, we are not going to charge by function execution or by that. Okay, so stay assured that our model will be way more way easier to budget for, essentially, than what you expect. So that you had to use to expect. So no, it's pretty amazing from my point of view. Okay, so yeah, cool. That was actually a very good question. Okay, and I think that's all. I don't see any more questions. So let's see, let me see on the, on social media if there is something on Twitter or anything. No, doesn't look like it. So I think we covered everything. It's...
Oh, there is a new question.
Oh, really?
Yeah. How have you found it building Platformatic Cloud on top of Platformatic?
This is a fun one. So basically, at this point, I am... our open source work is been mostly driven by what the cloud needs. So a good chunk, let me frame an interesting topic. So a few months back, so we open source Platformatic DB. And a few months back, we were thinking, but we started needing to have services without the database that would just interact with different API and orchestrate things. And then the concept of Platformatic Service was born, right? And Platformatic Service essentially exposes the bare minimum components for things, that you need to build APIs, but without the concept of a database, and comes a little bit more vanilla Fastify, essentially, if you pass me the term, and it's just Fastify on steroid. So you take a Platformatic Service and you can just use that. It has monitoring, logging, everything is set up. It has overload protection already built in. It has all the features that you need in a production Fastify application, but without the concept of a database attached. So it even supports TypeScript compilation because, you know, that's hard to do. So that's fun.
And plus, just to add to that, that was our, was always our goal, right? We wanted to build an open source driven platform, but the best way to build it is to build one. And so for us, Platformatic Cloud is an outcome of how we envision building digital platforms and platform in general.
Yeah. So,
and also our price point in terms of like giving it free right now and then adding more feature in the future will actually kind of like cater for people to have an entry level point to test how to build an ideal platform. So it's not just about deploying, it's about testing, seeing, and feeling firsthand, right? Every single feature that we are building.
Yeah, it's actually very, it's very thrilling to be able to do that. Very, very excited.
And for everyone that wants to use Platformatic Cloud in the future for, in your company or for anything, because of what Matteo just said, the whole Platformatic Cloud is purely CapEx. So that's actually the kind of interesting thing Platformatic itself was always born as how can we make it not an operational burden, but more an investment for the company. That's amazing. More business-y,
amazing.
Less fun thing to discuss.
Amazing. Yeah. Cool. So I just posted the blog post for Platformatic 0.19.0. Well, technical 0.19.1, because 0.19.0 was a few hours ago and I just already fixed the bug. So I'm sorry. I just published it for all of you to read, so you can read all the news on that article. So it's pretty amazing to see that. So I am very excited, to be honest.
Yeah, and like I said, it's just the first of a long series of announcements. So I invite everyone to keep following us on our social media, on our channels. We have a few new features. The spring, it's a great season, and we are starting to release more and more functionalities on our cloud and our open source, so stay tuned. in the next few weeks, we're going to announce something new, and then after a couple of weeks, something new, and we are going to go into that cadence of releasing more often.
Amazing. Okay, so if you just tuned in and missed the live video, or maybe you just watched lost the last few minutes where it went black for whatever missing reason that we didn't really understand why. You will be able to watch it on YouTube. It's going live right now. Okay, so. Again, thank you for being here, and I would say see you next time. Oh, a few reminders, folks. So we have a few bits. Later today, we will have later tomorrow. There will be Simon that will do a little bit of a deep dive in all the latest features and deploying things. Okay, and then on Wednesday, I will do. A little bit of a deep dive myself on the client, on the new client, okay? And stay tuned, because everything will be hopefully streamed and everything will hopefully work better than today. So we'll try to understand and fix whatever didn't exactly went well. And then we'll talk a little bit about the Q&A bits and so on and so forth. Cool, folks. Thank you for watching, and that's it.
Bye, everyone. Stay tuned.
Bye-bye. Bye.